Hi, my name is Dr. Brian Curtis. I'm one of the paleontologists here at Fossil Crates. Today, I'm here to talk to you about Cretoxyrhina mantelli. Now, this gray ghost has been drawn behind me with all the battle scars like sharks today have on them, was actually larger than the largest great white shark. This animal is believed to have exceeded over 24 feet in length. It's also, based on its fins, one of the fastest sharks to ever live. Today's fastest shark is the shortfin mako at 43 miles per hour. Cretoxyrhina is believed to have exceeded 40 miles an hour, whereas a great white shark exceeds 30 miles an hour. So here you have an animal that is larger and faster than today's most powerful, largest predatory shark. This animal's teeth have gained it the moniker Ginsu shark. Its teeth are slice and dice. They are pointed with little side jabs. The mouth comes down, severs out massive amounts of flesh. One of the cool things about Cretoxyrhina is even though shark skeletons are made of cartilage and not bone, and therefore almost never fossilize, we have a couple specimens that have been discovered of the Cretoxyrhina body. What's fascinating about that is Cretoxyrhina means sharp-snouted shark. It actually had a blunt nose based on body fossils. The Cretoxyrhina itself had a huge, powerful jaw. It likely could evert its teeth or mouth out to allow it to take an even larger bite than what sharks typically can take. And with this speed and a blunt nose, it could choose to ram prey instead of just bite prey. So one hypothesis is this gigantic shark would see something it wants to eat, burst out, run into it, stun it, take a huge chunk of flesh out from the now dazed victim. Cretoxyrhina in pretty much any other time or place would have been the apex predator. However, in the late Cretaceous of Kansas, where Cretoxyrhina is found, though it is found in many places all over the world, that's where it's most commonly found, in the Western Interior Seaway, which was the time when the United States was covered from an ocean from the Colorado Rockies to the Appalachian Mountains that reached from the Gulf of Mexico all the way north to Alaska. The center of our country was underwater. It was one giant seaway. Living at the same time, 70 million years ago, was Tylosaurus, a 50-foot long, extremely fast, powerful marine lizard whose closest relatives are the Komodo dragons. And Zephactinus, the bulldog fish, a 20-foot long bony fish with a massive bite and sharp teeth and quick speed as well. Cretoxyrhina has been found in the stomach contents to have Zephactinus and Tylosaurus parts. So it clearly ate them, but its teeth have been found in the stomachs of Zephactinus and Tylosaurus as well. So this was a aquatic creature world. There was no true dominant predator. There was predators everywhere. The savage ancient seas of Kansas would have been the most deadliest seas to have ever lived or swam in, possibly in the history of the world. Cretoxyrhina, unfortunately, went extinct. It didn't seem to leave any ancestors around. And so Cretoxyrhina is an evolutionary dead end. However, during its life, it gave us some of the coolest teeth that you can find, and lots of them. This giant predator is missed, but today's equivalent is the great white shark. But the great white shark didn't come around until 3 or 4 million years ago. I hope you've enjoyed this information. Please like and subscribe to our channel. Also, don't hesitate to post in the comments any questions, comments, or concerns you may have. Thank you kindly. Adios.